Murphy, a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Hey, good morning.
The lead story in the New York Times this morning is that herd immunity is unlikely. How big a deal is that?
That's a big deal. That just means it is so unlikely because of what's going on. You have so many things working against you. You have people, you have the anti-vaxxers, you have the people who are vaccine hesitant, you have the fact that variants are occurring, you know, daily almost, and that this is a global problem. So the other thing here in the United States why herd immunity isn't going to happen is that it's not a uniform effort to give the vaccines. There's pockets where very few people take the vaccines. And if that happens, you never really can get rid of it.
So going forward, I mean, we're going to be in better shape because a lot of people have taken the vaccine. So what does this mean for COVID going forward if there's no herd immunity?
What it means, it becomes a manageable endemic problem. In other words, you're going to have treatment. A lot of people are going to be vaccinated. They'll have a booster based on what the new variant is, whatever. I mean, it will become a manageable problem. But I think the point is, it's just not going to go away.
Got it.
You know, we really thought herd immunity, it will go away. It is not going to go away.
And what about India? Is there any hope for them? Are we responding quickly enough to help with that situation there?
Well, I mean, don't forget, India has 1.4 billion people. I mean, they got a big problem. But everywhere where these peaks occur, with the right mitigations, with masks, with social distancing, with the treatments that are out there, it can be controlled. So they just got to get on the ball and do it.
And they say the next evolution of these COVID vaccines could be a pill or a spray.
Yeah, well, so technology to the rescue. There's 277 vaccines in development. Not all vaccines are shots, by the way. There are sprays, drops, pills even, that can be a vaccine. So, you know, that's the future. So if we have hope in the future, you know, this could apply to many other diseases as well.
That's great. All right. A couple of questions here now from the viewers. Let's see if they pop up on the screen because they're not
here. All right,
here's
the first one.
I'm on an immune suppression drug. Would I benefit by repeating the vaccination every 3 or 6 months?
Well, this is a really good question. The NIH is actually studying this particular problem right now. We don't know. That is not an unlikely scenario, or a different kind of vaccine, or a different dosing schedule. So we don't know yet, but we hopefully will have an answer within months.
All right, let's take a look at the next question. I work in a small office, 20 employees. If everyone is fully vaccinated, do we need to keep wearing masks? What about a visitor?
Yeah, so this is, according to our current guidelines, you should still continue to wear a mask. Whereas if you were in your home with just family members, even family members that didn't live with you, you don't have to wear a mask. But the next step, in loosening up these guidelines is exactly refers to these kind of situations where you have a relatively small group of people, all vaccinated, you know, why bother with the mask? They're right in between the transition there. So the formal recommendation is to continue to wear a mask. The practical thing is that you don't, but it's going to move in that direction. As far as visitors concerned, they got to wear a mask until the vaccination rate gets higher.
All right, last question. We're going to test Dr. Murphy's knowledge of the Avengers. I know a few med students, and we were joking about how if someone got all three vaccines, that would be Thanos protection, like in the Avengers with the five different stones. Seriously, though, is there any danger in receiving more than one vaccine, or would you be more protected?
Yeah, I think they need to just go back to their video games and stuff like that. First of all, the protection from these vaccines, especially the Moderna and the Pfizer one, is so great. It would be very hard to make it even greater. It's not like the vaccines don't work well. They work terrific. There's another phenomena in immunology where you overstimulate, you have too much antigen presentation. And that actually can trip up the immune system, and you actually have a weaker response. So please don't do what these students think is a great idea. It's a great idea, but it just doesn't work.
And it's not a video game, it's a movie series. So people are going to get very upset about that, Dr. Murphy. I'm just...
Sorry about that.
Yeah. Got to work on that. I mean, you got to have... You can't be an expert on everything.
Stop reading all those books.
Go see a movie, all right? If you have any questions for Dr. Murphy, you can post it.
The theaters have been closed for quite a while.
Post your questions on our Facebook page, and we'll talk to him again tomorrow. Thanks again.
Okay, have a good day.
You too.